going on, bro? It's your man, Pat Caesar, Caesar LLC, Mobile Mechanic and Roadside Services, and now towing. Woo! It took me a while to get here, and it's been a long, very bumpy road, as you probably can tell by, well, I got anti-stabilization on this camera, so I guess you can't really tell. But either way, man, it's been a hard one, and I finally got me a truck, as y'all can see right there in the background. I got me a flatbed, two-car tow truck, man, and I'ma tell y'all, out of all the ones that I looked out for, why I got this particular truck, I'm pulling up to this place that I have been coming to quite often since I've got this truck, which is one of my favorite parts stores. And I need to just buy some stock here because I spent quite a bit of money here in the last few months while I've had this truck. So I'm gonna go in here, get these parts that I need, and explain to you what's going on with the truck, with the business, and everything else regarding it. So stay tuned, we'll get right into it right after the intro. Promise you'll catch me. So first off, I'm actually here because of this thing right here. I've been having to open the door from the outside, which is very inconvenient because I am on my second door handle. This is a 1988 F-250. It actually wasn't even a 350 actually, but Super Duty, because they didn't actually have 350s and 250s back then, or at least they didn't call them that. So you can see it's a flatbed, and y'all watch me go from Florida to by Georgia and everywhere in between trying to find a truck. I'll tell y'all a couple reasons why I got this thing and why it is driving my funds down incredibly fast. So originally, the guy that I bought this from, I got tired of looking first. Let's start there. I got tired of looking. I got tired of people lying to me. I got tired of trying to figure out how I'm gonna do this and expand my business of the mobile mechanic services. The year 88 is special to me because I was born in that year. So I happened to see this truck. Now, I've done went all over Florida, all by Georgia, South Tennessee, to find a truck. The problem with going north is that you keep finding rust buckets. You can find them in pretty good condition, but you know, when you get underneath it, everything is rusted or it is corroded, and I've dealt with it too much. I don't want to deal with it. I got my wallet. Okay, I got my wallet. So the next part to that is, I'm not a Ford guy, and y'all know I'm not a Ford guy, but it has a 7.3 IDI non-turbo. I have a set of turbos sitting at the house that I've been waiting to put on something, and this thing looks like it'll be a good candidate. But I've not been able to get past all the freaking issues that I've had with this truck. Mainly, well, right now, this is the last leak I gotta fix. And it's coming from my power steering reservoir. I had to change the cylinders, or get the cylinders rebuilt. The top cylinder, there's about six cylinders in here all together. And this cylinder for my Stinger does not, I just disconnected it because it was leaking profusely. You know, I probably paid way too much for this truck. I know I paid way too much for this truck. And my pockets are feeling it now because the little bit of funds that I had available between the insurance, which was almost $4,000 down, $1,200 a month, has dried up savings like bad. This thing is taking so much money from me, it is not even funny. And I've already, within the first few months of having it, has paid more in insurance than I've paid for the entire truck. So I don't know how sustainable this is, but either way, I got it because I wanted to carry two cars, and I figured if the towing didn't work, I would go into hot shotting, and I could still transport things. It's from 88, so I like that year, so I decided to get a truck from that year. It was close, and the guy actually did lie to me because everything was like perfect the first day, and then it's just gradually showing its true colors the more I've driven this thing. So I'm just making it work. Let me get in this parts store and get these parts, and we'll explain. I go to the next part of this. Okay, here we go here. 77178. There's two of these. Okay. Give me a second, y'all. All right, so I got my new handle. This truck, it means a lot to me because it is a tow truck. I've wanted a tow truck, I mean, pretty much since I was a kid. And, you know, it might have been a $10,000 mistake, put it like that. But, I've enjoyed it. Besides it breaking down, it's 5-speed. I mean, there was a lot of other ones. I actually wanted a snatch truck. But I got convinced not to buy one, and now I'm kind of kicking myself because I could have bought one for not a lot cheaper, but a little bit cheaper. And you know, been doing repos as well, because right now this thing is not trying to, it needs love, and it's slow. And it's not all that great on diesel. This is actually my first diesel. So I'm working through the motions, man. It's an old truck. Old trucks come with old truck problems. And you know, I'm still trying to learn a lot as far as it, you know, my customers, my equipment, you know, how to do different things. I've been in some gangster situations already, you know, from pulling people out of ditches to, I haven't done like a rollover or nothing like that yet, but you know, just crazy situations. People, you know, junking cars. I buy a lot of junk cars, and oh, that is gonna be something interesting too. I got a car that I got a surprise. I think y'all are gonna really enjoy it, because I've been looking for something I can purposely go out and not care if I blew it up. So this thing is loud, and I think I may not be able to record and have you guys hear me. I gotta fix the AC, like many other things that I have had to fix so far. So it's going. It's a slow and steady process, but slow and steady with continuous effort wins the race. So y'all got a tow truck. I got a tow truck. Y'all gonna see me out here. We're gonna be getting things together and going and picking up cars and trucks and vans and SUVs. So y'all stay tuned. Appreciate the love. If you haven't already, like video, subscribe to the channel, watch the progression, because I'm moving on up, y'all. Moving on up and moving up. Until next time, mi gente, be pro mundo beneficio. Peace.